Hello all, this is Nikum and welcome to our fourth session for Masterclass of General Awareness for all competitive exams in English. So basically today also we will see the important questions, okay, for this series, and then we will see the current affairs of I guess 9th and 10th, right? 2 days current affairs are left, so we will cover that, okay? So without wasting further time, let's start our video. Okay, so 16th question. That which state in India is the first one to get law on contract farming? Okay, very important concept for you, and definitely TCS, IBPS or NILET will ask question based on this affair, okay, because it is very important for you to understand. So the answer is Tamil Nadu. Okay, now we will go in very much deep to understand what is the contract farming and what are the things you should remember based on this affair. Okay, so first you will ask me that what is the contract farming, right? What is the contract farming? So basically contract farming means contract, okay, or we can say agreement between a buyer, okay, one is buyer and another is farmer, okay? So what will happen in that, they will make an agreement, okay, which is called contract farming, in where your buyer, those who will invest, okay, will provide all the tools or resources for farming, okay, and farmer will produce the our goods, our food, grains, like that, and directly it will give to buyer, okay? So it is the give and take process. So buyer will give tools or resources for the farming and farmer will give the food or grains, okay, so that buyer can sell that. So this is called basically contract farming. So this is very important to understand. Now on 27th of September, obviously you don't need to remember date, but just we are starting with some part, that's why it is very important to tell. So three bills basically passed, okay, total three bills are passed based on agriculture, and currently it is in news also, because you can see there is a farmer protest going on, right? So this is the thing for that only, okay, farmer bill. So that's why it is very important question for you to understand. Okay, so basically three bills passed. So first bill we will see, the first bill, you should remember the bill also, that farmers produce, trade and commerce. Okay, farmers produce, trade and commerce, and this is the basically promotion and facilitation act. Okay, so first bill, which is announced on 27 September, is your farmers produce, trade and commerce. Okay, so first understood the procedure, what is happening. Okay, suppose this is your farm, from here the farmer, okay, producing some grains, then the from here all the goods, grain or food, okay, goes to each city where we have APMC market. Okay, you already you heard about APMC. okay, full form is Agriculture Produce Market Committee. Okay, so from farm directly all the things, okay, we will get at APMC market, and then from APMC market in each city all the traders, okay, goods, means suppose this is city one, city 2, like that. So from APMC market basically distribution happens, okay, in all entire city. So now according to this bill, okay, now farmers what can do, farmers can do directly outside trading also, okay, they know, means there is no restriction that from farmer the good food or okay the food compulsory go to APMC. Now the farmer if want directly also trade, okay, so this is the purpose of this bill. Now the thing is that the state government, okay, the state government of each city, because in each city, in each state basically APMC market is there, okay, so state government cannot apply the taxes, okay, or it is tax free for farmers and traders also, okay, so those who are trading, traders, okay, they can also get tax free income with the help of this bill. Okay, so this is your farmers produce, trade, commerce bill meaning. You should remember the bill bill name. Okay, next we will see the second bill, that is your Essential Commodity Act. Essential Commodity Act. Okay, this is your second basically. So what is the meaning of this is that central government, okay, not state government, central government can delist the food list item. Okay, means some item of food is there, suppose there is a fruits, okay, there is some other items are there, so central government can delist it. Okay, means they will not include in the list, and also the advantage is that they cannot control the price of item also. Okay, central government cannot control the price of item and cannot control or cannot restrict the stock of that item. Okay, so stock control is also not there. Okay, so stock the buyer or trader can hold as much as stock they want. Okay, so basically this is the Essential Commodity Bill. And second, you should remember, sorry, third, that is your Farmers Empowerment and Protection Agreement. Okay, on price assurance and Farm Service Act. Farm Service Act. Okay, so this is the third bill that you have to remember. It just take care of the protection of the payment that the farmer will get from it. That's it. Okay, the first two are very important, first and second, that is your Essential Commodity Act also. So just remember that. Okay, central government in Essential Commodity Act, central government does not limit the stock holding, or it does not apply any taxes on that, or it does not also control the price, right? Control the price. So price also is not in hand of central government. Okay, so this thing you should remember about this. So yes, that's this information is very much essential and enough for this question. So let's move to our next question. 17-1, that who among the following has won the 37th Athens Marathon? Okay, so basically the answer directly I will tell you, that is your John Kipkorir Komen, D. Okay, so basically John is from Kenya. So if they can ask you, okay, about this also, the player. So you should remember that John Kipkorir Komen is from Kenya. Okay, now let's talk about Athens. Very beautiful city basically. So Athens is the capital of Greece. Okay, capital of Greece. And you can say Greece president obviously. So you should remember this, Greece president is Katrina. Okay, it's Katrina. Name is little big, but still remember Sakella Poloua. Okay, Sakella Poloua, or you can just remember Katrina also. Okay, it is, I guess it is a very easy for you to remember. And obviously Greece, okay, is in Euro, so the currency is Euro. Okay, so this much information is enough for this question. So just remember that 37th Athens Marathon won by John Kipkorir. He is from Kenya. Okay, and marathon runner he is. Which of the following ruler has given permission to East India Company to trade in India? Okay, Bahadur Shah Jafar, Humayun, Jahangir or Akbar? So basically your answer is Jahangir. Okay, that is C. Now we will discuss this because obviously from history, very important topic you can say. So that's why it is very important for us to discuss in little detail. So less detail in earlier, let's discuss then. So basically this is your the Mughal age topic. Okay, the Mughal age. Okay, and now in when I start with the Mughal age, then first the ruler is Babur. Okay, this just remember in this sequence only. Okay, so is the, so it is very easy for you to remember. So first is Babur. Okay, then second is Humayun. Then third one is Akbar. Okay, and then fourth one sorry 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 this is your Jahangir is there after Humayun. Third one is Jahangir, okay, and Akbar is basically son of Jahangir, eldest son. Okay, so this is the sequence you should remember always when we are talking about the Mughal age. Now the you can say the ruling period for Jahangir is 1605 to 1627. Okay, he is married to Noor Jahan, which is also her name was Meher. This question also asked, okay, that's why it is very important. So the real name of Noor Jahan is Meher Un Nisa. Okay, so this thing you should remember. Jahangir married to her. Then Jahangir write his biography, you can say, in the name is Tujuk A. Jahangiri. Tujuk A. Jahangiri. And basically he launches this in Persian language. Okay, at that time Persian language was very familiar with among the people. That's why Tujuk A. Jahangiri in this you can say his biography, he told all the things that happened at that time. And also it is in the language of Persian. Okay, then the important thing or question is that from East India Company, okay, just East India Company came to India to set up its business. Okay, so that's why at that time Queen Elizabeth was there. Queen Elizabeth, okay, so Queen Elizabeth sent Sir Thomas Rowe to Jahangir's court to take the permission for the factory. Okay, first obviously Jahangir say no for the factory, but later also the second time he agree. And the first factory, very important question again, okay, Sir Thomas Roy, you should remember compulsory to set up the factory. Okay, East India Company sent Sir Thomas Roy to the Jahangir court. Okay, just remember this. Tujuk Jahangiri you should remember. The real name of Noor Jahan is you should remember. Also, the first factory of East India Company is set up at Gujarat, that is your Surat. Okay, so first factory setup of first factory of East India Company set up at Surat. Okay, so that's why it is very important to remember also, because this question already they ask many times in many competitive exam. You will see this question. Okay, very famous question actually, but this question also very important. This also very important. Okay. So yes, this discussion is enough for this question. Let's move further. Who among the following has been appointed as the band ambassador or ambassador of India to the Republic of Mali? Okay, so the answer is Anjani Kumar. So you should remember this, that the ambassador of India to the Republic of Mali is Anjani Kumar. Now just we will see about Mali basically. So Mali is the country, okay, and the capital you should remember. They can ask you the capital, so it is your Bamako. Okay, Mali, Bamako. Currency you can say West African franc. Okay, West African franc. And president, of course we have to remember president also. Okay, currency, capital and president we have to remember. Ba Nadav. Okay, Baha Nadav. So BHNDAW. So just remember this, is enough for us that for this question. So let's move further. Okay, and today's last question, that who has been appointed as the new country manager of Google India? Okay, so obviously he is Sanjay Gupta. So you should remember that new country manager is Sanjay Gupta. Okay, about Google. So Sundar Pichai is the CEO of the Google. Okay, headquartered in California, US, right? You should remember this. So this was our today's 5 question. Now some of the students asked me that to take more questions, okay, but if you can see, okay, in these 5 questions also we covered lots of questions. So today also approximately we cover 15 to 20 questions, okay, by discussing 2 important topics. So that's why it is very important for you, and don't worry about that. The questions are now we complete 20 questions. Okay, so just see whether you are remembering all the things or not, right? Because 20 questions are more than, in this 20 questions, total 20 questions, we did almost 100 questions, I can say, about you. Okay, because we discuss in detail, that's why. So approximately 100 questions we till now we did in the last 5 videos. This was the your fifth part, I guess, fourth part. So yes, now we will see the current affairs of 9th and 10th December. Okay, so we are on website. So let's start with 9th December current affairs. Okay, So first we have national. So Kiran Rijiju launches second edition of Fit India Cyclone. Very important question. So just remember Kiran Rijiju, okay, and second edition of Fit India Cyclothon. So in this also you should remember that one point was there, the sports minister Kiran Rijiju, okay, the Kiran Rijiju is sports minister. So just remember, and the second edition of Fit India Cyclothon, okay, this also you should remember. Then PM Modi virtually inaugurates construction work of Agra Metro project, okay, so this is not much important, so you can skip that, you can skip this. Center launches QRMP scheme for GST payers. Very important question for you again, that QRMP scheme, okay. So basically the QRMP scheme is for small taxpayers, okay, under the GST system. So especially they launches for them. The full form, that's quarterly return filing and monthly payment of taxes, okay. So for small taxpayer, the central government or center launches QRMP scheme, okay, for GST payer. Basically they are for businessmen, okay. So this thing very important, full form compulsory, they will ask you, you will see this question. So let's move further. Then obituary is there, okay, just skip that. Okay, appointment and registration, okay, very important question again. Anil Soni appointed as the first CEO of the WHO Foundation, okay. Anil Soni, very important question for you. The headquarter of WHO is your Geneva, Switzerland, as you already know, okay. Then in important dates, always this is you remember, 9 December we celebrated International Anti-Corruption Day, okay, and the theme is recover with integrity. So just remember 9 December International Anti-Corruption Day and the theme is recover with integrity, okay. Then awards, in awards we can say Raj Kamal Jha wins Rabindra Tagore Literacy Award, Literacy Prize, very important again. Remember the name Raj Kamal, okay, which is a journalist author Raj Kamal, and also for what literature or novel he got the prize. So the novel name or literature name is The City and the Sea, okay. So The City and the Sea novel is written by Raj Kamal also, they may ask you the question. So that's why Raj Kamal is very important name for you, just write in your notes. Then okay, that's enough for this, let's move further. Okay, next is your ICAR wins 2020 King Bhumi Bol World Soil Day Award, okay. So basically the first question is that World Soil Day on 5th December, okay, already we studied. So on 5th December we celebrated World Soil Day. Now the chances to ask this is again increases because of ICAR win, okay. ICAR is your Indian Council Agriculture Research, so just remember this, very important. And the motto, it is not important but still, stop soil erosion, save our future, okay. That is the, I guess it is the theme, it was the theme for World Soil Day, just check that. The theme was similar like this. And the ranking, India ranks 10th in Climate Change Performance Index 2021, very important, all the points remember, okay. So India at 10th place, Climate Change Performance Index 2021. And okay, this score is not important that much, it is the second time in a row, okay. Okay, yeah, so first country is not given, I guess. Okay, fine, then first country is not given. Okay, so see, none of the country got the first three positions, okay, because this is they can't satisfy or they can't make the target of Paris climate. So just remember the rank of India, that is 10, and if you want then you can remember the fourth position, that is Sweden, okay. So just remember this also, and that's enough for this. So this was your current affair of 9 December, right. Now let's move to the our 10 December. So click here, okay. 11 December we will discuss tomorrow video, in tomorrow video, till then just go through it, then in this summary video you will again revise your things, okay. So this will be your advantages. In this summary video basically just you write your notes, and we are obviously going through again, so it will be revision for you, okay, and short notes for you. Just wait for a few seconds. Yes, it's loaded. So yes, first is international current affair. Mount Everest declares 86 centimeter taller by Nepal and China, okay. That was very important, but still if you you have to remember the height of Mount Everest, okay. So height is 8844 meter, claimed by China and claimed by Nepal, okay. So forget this, the new height of Mount Everest has been calculated 8848.86 meter. Okay, just remember this data, very important. The new height of the Mount Everest is 8848.86 meters. Okay, that's it for this. And okay, so basically in the Survey of India they declare 8848, now it is just 0.86, okay, increase in that. So let's move further in national affairs. So in national affair, what you have? PM Modi inaugurates Virtual India Mobile Congress. Okay, so IMC, so not very much important. Just remember the theme of the IMC, that is inclusive, innovation, smart, secure, sustainable. Okay, they may ask you this question, that Indian Mobile Congress. Okay, then Gwalior Orcha in UNESCO's World Heritage City list, very important. Just remember compulsory, very important, all these things. Okay, so read this full and just make your notes, that in UNESCO's World Heritage City, Gwalior and Orcha is there. Okay, so this is important. And then remember all this point, very important. The next affair is your about Gwalior. Okay, so about Gwalior also it is given, this famous spot is Sun Temple. Okay, Sun Temple is located at Gwalior. Jal Vilas Palace is located at Gwalior. Memorial of Tansen is located at Gwalior. So like this they may ask you the questions. Okay, that's why just remember this. And also in Orcha, the Orcha meaning the hidden palace. Okay, it is a little deep, but yes, you can remember. And Raj Mahal, Jahangir Mahal. Okay, Jahangir Mahal, just we saw na the Jahangir new question. So Jahangir Mahal is located at Orcha. Okay, so remember this. Then Ram Raja Temple, Rai Pravan Mahal and Lakshmi Narayan Mandir. Then in sports, Parthiv Patel announced retirement. Okay, so don't worry about this. Yulimar Rojas and Mondo Duplantis crowned 2020 World Athlete of the Year. Okay, so World Athlete of the Year. Who was the World Athlete of the Year? Yulimar Rojas and Mondo Duplantis. Okay, so just remember this. And they can ask you if they are. Okay, fine. So basically, triple jumper, Yulimar. Okay, so Yulimar is a triple jumper and the Swedish pole vaulter is the Mondo Duplantis. Okay, so just remember this, enough for this. Now the important thing is your dates. Okay, so 10 December, World Human Right Day, very important for you. So we will remember this one, Human Right Day. So World Human Right Day celebrated on 10 December, you should remember. And the theme is not dear, I guess. The year of theme, okay, yes, it is here. Recover better, stand up for human right. Okay, so this theme you should remember along with the word of the day. Then let's move further. That summits and MOUs. So basically, okay, not important, leave that. Okay, Invest India wins United Nations Investment Promotion Award 2020, very important. So just remember, Invest India win United Nations Investment Promotion Award. Okay, United Nations, Geneva, Switzerland. And UNCTAD, you should remember the full form, that is United Nations Trade and Development. Okay, so this is very important, United Nations Conference and Trade Development. So just remember this. Okay, ranking, Climate Change Performance Index, again the same thing is there, 10th place is, okay, we are on 10th place. 4th is Sweden, right? Just now we see in 9th December. Then banking economy for IBPS student, very important. Fitch rating lowers India GDP contraction at 9.4% for financial year 2021. Okay, so Fitch rating is very important. And I guess in Chandra Venus we will discuss about this rating, what is the rating, what is the application of that. Okay, so we will see shortly. And Nomura expect India to be fastest growing Asian economy in financial year 2021. Okay, so Nomura is, I guess, the Japanese Reader's and Brokerage House. Yes, okay, so this is not very important, but still this is very important, Fitch rating. And if you have time and if you can, then just get the Fitch rating meaning. Okay, because for you it is very important, and IBPS will ask you this screen, that's why it is very important. 9.4%, just remember. For TCS student, it is not much important for you, but still remember. Okay, because obviously they can ask you. So yes, this was the current affair summary for 9th and 10th December. Okay, tomorrow we will see in our next class about 11th of December. And yes, just like the session. And if you have any query, any doubt regarding any question, then just comment down below, we will discuss. in the questions. Okay, and I hope that just you are revising also, because now we completed 20 questions along with the current affairs. So that's why revision is very important. Also daily cards, I hope that you are looking at that English and 12 month current affair cards. Okay, so just look at that also. That is also very important for you, and keep your preparation very high level, and also more focus on your other sections, whether it is technical, whether it is maths, reasoning. Okay, for maths and reasoning also shortly I will upload the master classes. Okay, from the basic only, but it will be based on questions and concept like that. Okay, not from scratch. So, but obviously in question while explaining, as I'm explaining, as I explained for general awareness, I will go in deep and in very basic manner I will explain to you. Okay, so just if you have any query, then just comment down below, we will resolve it shortly. Okay, all the best.